Hi, this is Chris Brown, Technical Services Supervisor at Danfoss. In today's video, we're going to cover how to build a calculation for dew point in our Danfoss System Manager. So in the System Manager, we may be looking to calculate dew point for a few different reasons. So anything with any sweat heaters on reach indoors or on the HVAC side in a rooftop unit with humidity control, if there's not something our controller can already handle with the predefined tasks, then we'll have to look at building the logic through a calculation to control. So from the System Manager's main screen, if we go into configuration and then control, we'll want to jump into the miscellaneous tab and then the calculations tab. From here, we'll build a new calculation by double clicking on the top line, selecting any available calculation number that we would like to use. And then with that calculation listed here in the second portion of the screen, we'll double click on that to get into the setup of the calc. Here, dew point, since that's what we're calculating, this would be a temperature value. So we want to make sure the units that we're selecting are SI degrees Fahrenheit. Our style, as you can see here, we don't have a predefined style to calculate dew point, so we'll leave this as generic. We can give this a default name for the exercise here. And then we need to know what our data points are. So are we calculating indoor or outdoor dew point? If it's indoor, then we need to know what our indoor RH or relative humidity and then our indoor temp sensor values are, making sure they're assigned in the program. And then the same if we're calculating outdoor dew point in this calculation. We need to know what the outdoor temperature and the outdoor humidity values are so we can bring them in. So for an indoor humidity example, our first data point type, we'll make sure we're selecting SI degrees Fahrenheit here. And this will allow us to choose a temp sensor. I'll use the generic indoor temp sensor that the System Manager offers. This could be any temp sensor from a rooftop unit, depending on how you want to configure this, or something else completely different on the refrigeration side for anti-sweat heaters. Our second data point type, now we need to bring in our relative humidity value. So if we choose the data point type as a percentage, this will now give us any inputs that are based off of a percentage like our relative humidity. So we'll be able to select that from the list here. And now we have our two sensors that we need to calculate dew point. For our third data point type, now you will see an option here for dew point. And the catch there to keep in mind is that we need to have a temperature sensor and a humidity sensor already configured to see that option for dew point. If we haven't set these first two up already, the third data point type for dew point won't appear as an option. Now that we have those configured, our data point type for the third input will be the dew point option. Then you can see below it's already defaulted to the right options. So our temperature value will be based on SI1, which is our indoor temp sensor. Humidity will be based on SI2, which is our indoor humidity sensor. Now at the bottom half of the screen here, and this is where we say what we want the output of the calculation to be. We really just want this to be the third data point type, essentially, the dew point calculation. We'll clean this up a little bit. We don't need this second line or what's now become the first line that I deleted the first line. We don't need this line here. We really just need the true line because that's saying under any conditions, what do you want the result or the output of the calculation to be? So I'll double click here to get into our secondary screen to configure the results. I can delete this top option by double clicking on the type line and choosing delete. And then for the remaining line, so true, we want to leave in place. The type we want to change to dew 3, which would be our dew point value on line or data point type number 3 is where the number 3 comes from. So now we have that result just left at a value looking at the true conditions, which is any point in time, and it's going to output that dew point calculation based on the two temp sensor and humidity sensor rather that we configured in the top half. Thanks for watching our video. For more technical documentation and videos on our System Managers, please visit danfoss.com/supermarket support.